Hey guys, welcome to Car Guy 1999 Reviews as well as Quirk Auto Dealers. Today we have the heavily refreshed 2021 Volkswagen Arteon R-Line. This is an absolutely gorgeous car. I'll go ahead and I'll start talking about the differences once I find the window sticker, wherever they put that. But nice to see. Oh, that's why. Because whoever took it off did so with their razor hands. This is the SEL R-Line. Deep black pearl, Florence brown leather, 45175. Yeah, maybe if we didn't have Wolverine take the window stickers off. Different wheels for this new one. This R badge, I do believe, is new. Front end, lightly refreshed grille area. I think these vents down low are new. The interior is really where they spent a lot of their time. In the rear, I think it's very, very similar. I think the tail lights might be a little bit different. Maybe the lower part of the bumper, but other than that, pretty similar. Backseat area, pretty much the same. Front seat area, very noisy currently, but very, very different. Come on. Like the new engine cover. That's a big hood. I just took a step back and realized that. It takes this whole top of the fender with it. Man, it is actually pretty heavy too. But that could just be the dampers. Actually, it's a very unique hinge action because it goes up like this. So if you watch the hinge, it sets itself down like so. Back to Wolverine's sticker. Light's gonna be torn. Yeah, it is the 2.0. I think probably about 280 horsepower. New steering wheel, new touch sensitive buttons. Gauge cluster I think is the same, just the software and stuff that's in it is a little bit different. This, all the climates right here is all different as well. I like this for the fan speed. Drag your finger across. Same thing with the volume for the stereo. Pretty cool system. Hazard lights. Not that the Arteon was lacking luxury with the previous gen, I just didn't like that the interior had so much in common. Also, what they revised that I noticed is this right here now is soft touch, so you can rest your knee against it, or in the worst case scenario that you get into an accident, somebody T-bones you, when you hit it, it won't be like hitting like it is down here, so it's durable, but it won't be like hitting a rock. Nice little storage compartment here. Without further ado, let's take it for a drive. Love the new steering wheel. It's probably my favorite part. It's also the part that you use the most. So, well, that and the throttle pedal. Those are two very important things. put it into normal drive, actually we'll start off in comfort. Then we'll move up to sport mode. Instantly changes color on the gauges to let you know it's in a different mode. I think you can configure that. That's part of the ambient lighting that's in here. Go one step further into eco. Now it's blue with the gear saying E. Normal, it's also blue. Sport turns red. Custom is blue. We'll go into comfort. 2.0 has a ton of low down torque. Good amount of mechanical grip. Okay. This actually puts out more power than the Mark 7 GTI. So to put that in perspective, if you've driven a GTI, you know that they do feel really quick for what they are. So just multiply that, and the Arteon is like a four, well, all GTIs are four-door in America. A sedan GTI. It has good performance. I was going to say it's a four-door GTI, but that's the GLI. And if you think about it, too, for what you're getting for the price, this is really, really nice, especially with this refreshed interior. I thought it was very expensive for what you got with the previous generation. The interior just wasn't up to par for what I expected. This is very, very much up to snuff for what you would expect. Even in comfort mode, that throttle pedal is very, very touchy. It's a very sport-tuned experience. After just stepping out of the previous CC, we have a 2016 Volkswagen CC that I just stepped out of. You can definitely, they're very, very similar cars. Of course, the Arteon replaced the CC. Here, I'll go ahead, put it into sport. Instantly steering, a lot heavier. It's gonna hold gears for you. I can also try manual mode for you guys. Auto start stop. It is defeatable, which is a bonus. This is a normal torque converter automatic, whereas the CC was a DSG, but you still get some DSG farts too. Especially between gears 1 and 2. Man. And then I've driven a tuned version of one of these, I think it was a 2019 or 2018. Driven a tuned version, and that thing hauls even more so. With a tune, I mean, this at the end of the day, this is a 2.0. So, same motor that's in the GTI. We all know the aftermarket on GTIs is very strong. So the Arteon does have a good amount of support, especially through APR and stuff like that. However, out of the box, I like it a lot. Very, very fun to drive. Also extremely luxurious. I'm not sitting here begging for anything different. It's just... it's just perfect. Hill start assist. And we'll go ahead and test out the backup camera and sensors. Thank you so much for watching. Please like, share, and subscribe. I will see you all in the next one.